Okay, you're gonna have to excuse me on this one. I'm gonna be talking about Justice League Volume 5, Forever Heroes. We've got Jeff Johns, Ivan Reis, and Doug Monk, part of the New 52 line. I did enjoy the comic. Probably worth $5 or $10, depending on how much you like the characters involved. Art is good. Really good art, actually. I'm not really sure, though, what else to say about this book, because it's been so long and there's not much that sticks out in this, except that we follow mainly, if I remember correctly, Cyborg. And what has happened is that the bad Superman, as it were, from the other alternate universe, or Ultraman, is that what they call him? I don't remember what they call him, but it's where everything's reversed. So, like, that Spider-Man has to eat kryptonite, green kryptonite, to keep his powers. It's kind of like the reverse world and everything in it. And his computer side, as it were, separated from his human side, and it just left him, you know, all armless, legless, you know, just a flopping torso, kind of. And his dad finds him, stabilizes him, you know, gets him back together, gets his parts back together, and he has to go confront him. Because the problem is that the Justice League is not really going to be able, or anyone's going to be able to fight off the, I think they call themselves the Injustice League. The bad guys, basically, all the reverse, you know, Superman reverse, Wonder Woman reverse, Flash reverse, Green Lantern, I think they call them Power Ring or something like that, which is fueled by fear. It's all kind of reversed, all the powers and everything. Because the computer system from Cyborg's computer side has basically seized control of every single electronic thing on the planet Earth. So no one can use, you know, you can't do anything or go anywhere, because they've got, you know, their own Flash, their own Superman, to their own Batman, which I think they call Owlman, that can keep track of everyone. And with the computer system monitoring everything on planet Earth, there's just no way, all the satellites, everything, that they really can do much of anything. So they got to take him offline first. And it is kind of cool, because he does recruit the, what do they call them? I think they call them Metal Men, who are quite interesting group of characters that's well worth meeting. So like I said, it's probably worth about $5 or $10. Of course, at the end, he does manage to defeat his computer side, and they're ready to go forth and go about saving the world, which we find in Justice League Volume 6, Injustice League. And we've got Jeff Johns and Doug Monkey and Jason, is that Paul Bach? And in this one, they team up a lot with Lex Luthor. Lex Luthor, I think they've defeated, you know, the Injustice League, as it were. And Lex Luthor wants to become part of the Justice League, and they're not real keen on that, because nobody really trusts him or believes him. And they put him through some tests. I think Wonder Woman even uses her lasso on him at one point to try to get some answers out. And it's clear he's still not, like, a really good guy. But there is... The whole reason that the Injustice League came to this Earth was because something destroyed their universe. And it's also going to come here. So they want to prepare the planet by being jerks, basically. Survival of the fittest type stuff. To fight off this whatever it is. So that's the ultimate end goal. And Lex Luthor's working with, basically, the Justice League, in a way, to try to get ready for what's coming. Well, Lex Luthor was hiding a virus of sorts, and it gets out, and it makes everyone really sick and starts to degrade them. It does take a little bit of time to do it, I think maybe a couple days or something like that, but during the second phase of the virus, people start developing superpowers, and they seem to be not exactly random, something based on the person. Like at one point in the book, Batman does get infected and he goes blind, but he can see in sonics, and he can even let out like a sonic attack of some sort. So somewhat related to Batman. No one knows how this works, because the whole point that Lex Luthor was trying to make this virus was so they would get rid of Superman's powers and make him mortal. But it was completely ineffective on Superman, so he just kept it locked up for now because I guess he didn't know what else he was going to probably keep trying to make it so it works on Superman. But they do end up getting a cure for that and going through that. And saving everyone from the vaccine. Although, from the virus, rather. But there is an interesting side effect, which is good to set up other things. The vaccine leaves approximately, they say, as best they can estimate, about 3% of those afflicted retained their superpower, or whatever power it was. So that's definitely setting up things in the future where there's a little bit more powered people in this universe. I guess you could argue that that's kind of like a mutation. But I think it's more likely that it's an updated version of what being a mutant is. I mean, people remember Peter Parker was bitten supposedly by a radioactive spider. That's back when we thought radiation, you know, you get a little radiation crazy, things will go crazy. When that was kind of made. And of course, now we realize it doesn't really work like that. So it makes more sense a little bit that it would be some sort of virus that would get in and actually change your DNA that would potentially give people powers instead of just these random mutations, so to speak. So I thought it was kind of cool and is definitely a way to inject a little bit more power and different powers too, because they're psychological based, so it's not like they're all going to be Superman clones. You know, they're all going to be just flying around invulnerable. A lot of their powers are going to be extremely unique. Like, I think at one point somebody can, like, open up many black holes, you know. So it would be really weird, bizarre stuff. You probably pay maybe, like, $5. If you're a real big Justice League fan, probably $10 for the book. That would be about what I did. Of course, I checked them out from the library, so I didn't have to pay anything. Yay, for me. If you have any questions or comments, please leave them below.